is good.
Hello viewers, welcome to LMTV, a station where you watch and learn. Your tutor is Mr. Wanyoike, an agriculture teacher. In today's lesson, we inform two lesson 16. Our topic is crop production 3 and subtopic nursery practices. On to the lesson objectives. By the end of the lesson, the learner should be able to, number one, define the term nursery bed, seed bed, seedling bed, and number two, explain the importance of a nursery bed. On to the terms used, we have a seed bed. What is a seed bed? A seed bed, it is a piece of land where plants are grown, where plants are planted and grow to maturity and harvested while on the same piece of land. What is a nursery bed? A nursery bed is a piece of land which is prepared for raising seedlings which are to be transplanted later. And the term number three, we have seedling bed. This is a special type of a nursery bed for raising where the overgrown seedling, big seedling from the main nursery are transplanted, are removed and grown there before the time of transplanting is attained. Then we go to our diagram here. There is a diagram that demonstrates what a seed bed looks like. You can see it is a portion of land where the seedling or seed are normally grown and they are watered while on the same piece of land till maturity. And therefore they are harvested upon reaching maturity age. Then we go to the types of nursery bed. The first one, we have vegetable nursery bed. You can see it there. It is used for raising seedlings for vegetables. For example, you can have the one for tomatoes, you can have the one for the cabbage, the one for kale, and so on. Then we have, what are the importance of nursery bed? The first one, facilitate production of many seedlings. The second one, facilitate easy carrying out of management practices, for example, watering, weeding, pest control. It is very easy when you carry these management practices in a nursery. Then the third one, facilitate planting of small seedling that actually develop into a very healthy and strong seedling. And because there is good taking care of the seedling, and that's why they end up becoming very strong and very healthy. Then we have excess seedling as a source of income, and therefore they are sold by the farmer to get an extra coin. Then we have enables the provision of the best conditions for seedling. It is easily managed. A nursery bed is easily managed, and therefore it is very, very possible to provide the best condition. For example, you can have a shed that will provide the shade to the seedlings below the shade, so that you can reduce the rate of transpiration. And by reducing the rate of transpiration, meaning that the seedlings will continue growing in a good manner. Then we will go to the next one, that is facilitates selection and transplanting of only the healthy and vigorous growing seedling, giving them a good head start. It means that those big seedlings which are on the nursery bed, they are uprooted, they are transplanted to the main seed bed, while the other which are young, they are left there to continue with growth. Then enables the raising of many seedlings in a given area. The nursery bed is the one which is normally carry a lot of seedlings in a per unit area, meaning that you can there is no competition for nutrients because you can provide adequately for the nutrients to the soil. Then we have, it allows other land operation to go on in the main seed bed while the crop is growing in the nursery bed. Therefore, you can continue cultivating the other crops as you wait for the seedling to grow before the time of transplanting is reached. Then that marks the end of today's lesson. And I will give you assignment. The first question, differentiate between seed bed and seedling bed. And the second one, give three uses of seed bed, shed constructed above a nursery bed. You give three uses of a shed constructed above a nursery bed. For reference, you can refer from Secondary Agriculture, Student Book 2, and the publisher is the Kenya Literature Bureau. Then for more information, if you'd like to clarify something from us, you can reach us at Elim TV using the following addresses. The first one we have through SMS using the number which is well displayed for you there. Then you can use YouTube at Elim TV. You can reach us through Facebook platform at Elim TV. And finally, you can use Twitter at Elimu_KE. Thank you for joining me in my lesson. Till next lesson, goodbye.